Thomas Paine. Thomas Paine. Thomas Paine. Sam Adams. Sam Adams. Sam Adams. Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin. These men spoke up for what they thought was right. From their courage came such documents as the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution of the United States. From their willingness to speak what was sometimes unpopular but right, we enjoy such liberties as freedom of speech, the right to keep and bear arms, and freedom of religion. There are those who still wish to oppress our freedoms, and there are still patriots willing to stand up and defend life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Men like Zeb Bell, who honor our founding fathers and what they stood for. It's now time for Zeb at the Ranch, speaking up and defending your freedoms. Brought to you by Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers and all of the other great advertisers on the program. And now, Zeb Bell.
Oh, good morning and Merry Christmas. As Christmas carols fill the air with joy and merriment, as the chime of church bells echoes all around and prayers reach out to God, Deanne and I wish you a joyous Christmas and a happy new year. Good morning, everybody. Here comes Kate Smith, and God bless America. We need a patriot to call with our Pledge of Allegiance. Good morning. Oh, thank you very much. Kate Smith and God Bless America. Good morning, everybody. Zeb Bell, Zeb at the Ranch. And, of course, brought to you by our major sponsor, your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. All seven locations serving you. Thank you very much. Along with some of our great advertisers like Western Way Services, always at your disposal. Call them. Get on the route service, 734-6969. All right, now, without further ado, let's go over the river and through the canyon and over to K-Bar. And do we have a Pledge of Allegiance person?
We do, sir.
All right. Go ahead, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, man, I'll tell you what, Killed Man on the phone here with us, and thank you so much. Excellent job on the pledge, and to you, your family, Merry Christmas. Thank you so much.
Merry Christmas to you and yours.
All right, buddy, take care of yourself. All right, thank you. Good guy right there. Very, very good guy. Merry Christmas. Thank you very, very much. Time for the weather, and the weather brought to you by Cheney Flooring and Home Design at 1228 Oakley Avenue in Burley. Look for the blue door or give them a call at 678-6945. All your carpet and flooring, kitchen construction, home decor items, whatever you need to make your home a Christmassy home, you better stop in today at Cheney Flooring and Home Design. And they've also got gift certificates, too. Hey, great shopping at Cheney Flooring and Home Design. Here's Gina with the weather.
Here's your weather forecast as we are inching our way closer towards Christmas, but we still have about 11 days left. Looks like partly cloudy skies for today, slightly breezy winds out of the southwest, right around 14 miles an hour, high of 28 for today. Tonight, low of 21. Tomorrow, expecting some afternoon snow showers, about a 50% chance. Still going to be windy out of the west, about 15 miles an hour, high of 30 with an overnight low of 23. Cloudy and 33 for Thursday, and partly cloudy and 40 for Friday. Yesterday's high was 31. The overnight low was 27. That's your weather for Zeb at the Ranch.
And she does a great job. Thank you, Gina. I appreciate it. Cheney Flooring and Home Design bringing you the weather. And they're located at 1228 Oakley Avenue in Burley. Kyle, Whitney, the whole crew wishing you and yours a very Merry Christmas. Big sale coming up on Thursday at the Burley Livestock Sale Yard, 1100 Occidental Avenue in Burley. Number to call for consignment information or sale information in general, 678-9411. Merv May, Cade Roggy, Lance Udy. The sale that works for you. Starting time at 10 a.m. every Thursday, Burley Livestock Sale Yard. This Thursday, don't you miss it. I got to remind you that tomorrow is a very, very special day. We are going to be boxing everything up here and moving on over to Denny's Restaurant at 611 Overland in Burley, and we're going to have our remote broadcast all morning long, 8 to 11 tomorrow morning. And we are so blessed. We are going to have some of the Burley High School choir, and they're going to be singing Christmas carols in Denny's. It's going to be beautiful. And door prizes, Santa Claus is going to be there. I talked to him this morning. He just finished loading the sleigh. And we're going to have loot in the boot for the needy families. And, of course, Ken Mort's going to be singing. So it's just going to be a lot of fun tomorrow morning at Denny's Restaurant. Come down and have breakfast with us at Denny's Restaurant. 611 Overland in Burley, the greatest of breakfast, lunch, and dinner. You're going to love the menu and the people at Denny's. I guarantee it's going to be a lot of fun. Wheels, I'm going to ask your help on something this morning. If you could just turn your mic on for a second. And
yes,
I really would appreciate it if somehow you could kind of monitor what's going on in L.A. with the threat against the school buses and that possible bomb threat, because that's news that absolutely should be brought out to everybody. So if you kind of monitor that situation and let me know if you hear anything, let me know, would you please?
Yes, sir, will do.
All right, Wheels, thank you very much. Good man.
You're
right
welcome.
There. Old Wheels doing a good job. Don't forget Daryl's Cleaners, 1223 Albion Avenue in Burley. You talk about doing a good job. Holy smokes, I'm really blessed to know Kevin and Cindy. And over the years, they have taken care, many, many years, they've taken care of making sure that my clothes are the way I want them. You know, my Wranglers, sports shirts, jackets, everything, they do a wonderful job. And they will for you, too. So stop in and see them today at Daryl's Cleaners. They wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year from 1223 Albion Avenue in Burley, Daryl's Cleaners. Somebody else, too, that wishes you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year is SafeLink Internet, 677-8000, the number to call. No contract options, no credit checks, unlimited data, and they really do a great job. Anytime we've ever, and very minimal, had a problem, they've been here, Johnny, on the spot. They are a great service-oriented company. Number one choice for wireless Internet, SafeLink Internet. Call, get on the program, 677-8000. Wonderful people. All right, it's your turn. Give us a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. I had a lady call me and kind of chew on me a little bit. And I took it for a couple of minutes. And then finally I let her know in no uncertain terms my opinion. But she said that you shouldn't be so down on the Obama administration. You shouldn't be so down on the refugees coming into this country. And then she went on and gave us the standard line about, oh, we're all refugees. Basically, we're all immigrants. You know, the same speech you've heard 1,000 times. Well, I finally had enough and started throwing facts out to her. And that ended the conversation. I will point out to you, and this is straight from Judicial Watch, who is, by the way, suing the Department of State for documents related to President Barack Obama's refugee and resettlement program. And they are saying that Obama has been really pulling the wool over the American public's eyes with refugees. Let me just read this part to you. The Obama administration doesn't want Americans to know about how it places refugees from terrorist states into local communities. The fact we had to file a federal lawsuit to obtain basic information about Obama's dangerous refugee plans should tell Americans and also our Congress that the Obama administration has something to hide about refugees, terrorism, and national security. Right there, I want to pause and I want to point my finger at individuals and groups in this community, such as the College of Southern Idaho, and also the Times News. And I want to let them know just absolutely how I am pointing my finger at them in disgust for their acceptance of this refugee program of really no knowledge of who these people are or what they represent. And then turning around and calling us bigots and hate mongers and irresponsible and loudmouths for complaining about this situation. I am not going to let this drop. We are being led by the most naive, clueless, and arrogant president ever in the United States history. And here's a point I want you to ponder for about 30 seconds or so while I do a commercial break. Why? Why is he and this administration so absolutely bent on protecting the enemy with political correctness and a lack of ability? Call me on that. Ladies and gentlemen, our thanks go out to Burley, all of our sponsors across Twin Falls, Burley, Jerome, everywhere. And we want to say thanks to Ramsey Heating and Electric. I'm so blessed to have them on my program, and they have been for many, many years. And for all your heating and electrical needs, don't forget they're located at 2600 Overland Avenue in Burley. And the number to call, 678-0459. They're open 7:30 to 5 Monday through Friday. And they, oh, by the way, a little chilly out there on that linoleum floor, wasn't it? Well, you forgot to get a clean furnace filter. They've got them all for you at Ramsey Heating and Electric at 2600 Overland Avenue in Burley, where they provide warm winters and cool summers. You stop in and see them today. Come on, give me a call. And what are your thoughts about this administration and kind of a clueless approach to what's going on with our security? And what's going on in the world with all the bad people, especially ISIS and Al-Qaeda, etc.? Why? Why is this administration basically protecting the enemy and looking the other way? Call me. Christmas wishes this morning go out from Butte Irrigation on 116 South, 600 West of Paul, and on Kimberly Road. You better believe it, your Zomatic dealer, they will get you wet. Ah, yes, they wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas. Along with General Ben and the crew at Burley Glass, 1029 Overland in Burley. Number to call, 678-1459. Thank you for all the business at Burley Glass. Thank you and Merry Christmas. Senator Kelly Anthon would like to wish all the people of the Minnecash area a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. This is a good man. We're going to hear good things about him. And Merry Christmas from Senator Kelly Anthon. And also wishes for a very Merry Christmas from Representative and Speaker of the House, God Bedke. He wishes all his constituents a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good morning, caller. You're on the air.
Why that Obama administration gets away with it is because of people like Doug Mon and them people from the CSI who are for the refugee program and naive and don't have any common sense. There is a lot of people out there just like them in different communities. And then the people like you and I, we our voices aren't heard loud enough. We don't speak up loud enough. I realize you do, but Deb, you know there's a ton of people out there that are just sitting back thinking like we do and just not saying anything.
I agree with you.
Letting it happen.
No, I totally agree with what you said, and I want to emphasize and also elaborate a little bit on what you said. I said yesterday on this program, and I'll maintain, that we have got to unify our voices and speak out and let everybody know our complete disdain for what's going on. Here's something that I want you to give me a response to. It has been brought up since yesterday morning that Homeland Security and the FBI and the State Department should have and could have known more about the Muslim female killer because of her Facebook rants and her postings about jihad and how she hated the United States. Nobody checked on that. So now, those killings in California, honestly, by checking her out and basically not allowing her into this country, it could have stopped the needless killings of those innocent people. What are your thoughts about a lack of security for you and for me and for everybody else?
I 100% agree with you. The political correctness in this country is going to cause a lot more of them kind of problems. And I'll tell you another one. The neighbor that knew things were going on in there, because of the clock boy, she didn't want to be... The clock boy got brought to the White House. He got, I heard, a $6 million lawsuit, and he won. And she didn't want to be a victim of that political correctness by blowing a whistle on them. And she could have saved 14 lives and all the pain and suffering, too, if she would have just done what you're supposed to do, see something, say something. But because of the clock boy getting invited to the White House, she was scared to say anything, and she didn't say anything. And now 14 people are dead because of that.
And by the way, the other 21 or 23 that were injured, including the 14 that were deceased, all of the residual effects in the families, and all the aunts and uncles and grandmas and grandpas and the wives and the husbands and the kids, this is absolutely one of the most heinous acts I've ever heard of. And for our president... And his lack of ability and knowledge, or whatever you want to call it, and the State Department, Homeland Security, and the FBI, not to have seen the red flags, I hold them accountable.
I hold them accountable also, Devin, for the people like Doug Mon and them at the CSI. Something has to happen close to home for them to open their eyes. Even this right here didn't really open their eyes. They're just going to hold off a little bit. Well, let's say they're going to hold off a little bit. But behind the scenes, they probably are not holding off a little bit. Something has to happen close for someone like them to open their eyes, and I don't know if it's ever going to happen.
I appreciate your call, and from my house to yours, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, too, and keep up the good work.
Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate that. Let me just throw one little fact out here from the Judicial Watch. And this is a quote from them that was sent to me early this morning. And I want to get to the bottom of this here. For the cost, now listen to this just very carefully. For the cost of resettling one Middle Eastern refugee in the United States for 5 years, the United States could pay to support the resettlement of 12 refugees in the Middle East in their own area. Think about that. For the cost of resettling one person here in the United States, we could have supported the resettlement of 12 refugees in the Middle East, in their own environment, in their own country, in their own safe zone. We are being duped into a complete train wreck. Calls are welcome, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Don't weaken on this. Give me a call, Burley Physical Therapy and Rehabilitation. If Nick is listening this morning, I forgot to call him yesterday. My son and his family stopped up here, and we had a kind of a pre-Christmas dinner and everything, and I just got sidetracked. I apologize. Burley Physical Therapy and Rehabilitation, 1263 Bennett Avenue, Suite 2 in Burley. All the great physical therapists, and of course all the exercise programs, sports medicine, hydrotherapy pool. I've been in that pool many, many times. Great, great hydrotherapy pool, helping you get back to being and feeling you. That's the objective. So please give them a call or stop in. Burley Physical Therapy and Rehabilitation. Number to call, 678-1191. Really, really super nice people. You know, I got to stop here for a second, because when I start talking about super nice people, that leads me to talk about a gentleman that I've had the occasion to know for a long, long time, and that's, of course, Colonel Dale. Colonel Dale at the Book Plaza and Gift Stop. You better believe it, 222 West 11th Street in Burley. Now listen carefully to this. They're having a big Christmas giveaway with over $1,000 in prizes, gifts, and cash, and you got to register to be a potential winner at the Book Plaza with books and gifts and jewelry. I don't know how many thousands upon thousands of books they've got, but they have what you're looking for at the Book Plaza, 222 West 11th Street in Burley. Really great folks. All right, it's your turn. Give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. For the people that called me again after the program, I just really lose a lot of respect for people that call me after the program to chew on me. Now, I do not mind. I want to make this poignantly clear. I do not mind if you call me and talk about any issues that are on the program. But if I give out my cell phone, which is 312-2976, and you specifically wait to chew on me after the program because you didn't have the nerve to let your voice be heard on the radio, that is a little upsetting to me, and I will let you know that. But to the people that are gullible and unknowledgeable about how serious this refugee program or the immigration plan into this country is right now in general, I am going to make an advocacy here this morning that we follow the dictates of not only Donald Trump, but many others in the House and also the Senate that are saying, wait a minute, we don't know who these people are, and we don't know what they represent. And I'm going to use these words, the incompetency of believing that everything is coming down the yellow brick road like at the Wizard of Oz, that the Times News tries to print in their paper that all the blowhards, the hate mongers and everything that are questioning the refugee center and the CSI refugee center itself, they haven't got a clue. They haven't got a clue as to who these people really are. And I really don't care what they print about me. I really don't care what they say about me. They can call us names if they want to. But this administration has dropped the ball. And our security is at stake. When you hear continuous stories about Homeland Security, well, we don't know who these people are. FBI, Comey, well, we just don't have the necessary precautions in place to make sure that we know who these people are. And then you hear about the State Department and what Obama is trying to hide and the costs of bringing these people in, and it's at our expense. Would somebody just back up and wave the red flag for a few minutes and say, whoa, stop! Let's let a little common sense prevail here instead of throwing out the bigot and hate monger names. Calls welcome 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. I am very, very blessed, as I said, with my stable of sponsors and advertisers. And when I talk about my advertisers, I got to talk about Berry Equipment and Rental. Three locations serving you in Twin Falls on Addison Avenue West, and then also on South Lincoln and Jerome. And then old Nick and Juan and the whole crew over there at 159 West Highway 30 in Burley. Oh boy, have they got the equipment at all three locations to get any job done right. And I mean that. Whether it's the Bobcat skid steer loaders, the Coyote tractors, or the telehandlers, the rototillers, the great big Doosan loaders. I mean, the list goes on and on. Whatever you need, it's right there, and they can tell you and teach you how to work those so that it gets the job done for you. Berry Equipment and Rental, Twin Falls, Jerome, and 159 West Highway 30 in Burley. Want to say also a big thank you to a lovely lady that has been on this program a lot, and a lot of people appreciate what she does too. Mount Harrison Audiology and Hearing Aids, Christine Pickup, the doctor of audiology, right across from the Minidoka Hospital Emergency Room, and the number to call for a hearing screening. You do not want to miss the grandkids unwrapping the packages. Hey, what did he say, Martha? You want to hear all the Christmas carols. You want to hear everything. Well, be sure and call for a hearing screening today. Absolutely. The number, 312-0957. That number again, 312-0957. Mount Harrison Audiology and Hearing Aids. You call her today. Oh my goodness. Listen to this. This is insane, and it goes right along with some of the PC that we've been talking about. A Philadelphia school is banning the book The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. I know you probably looked at the radio if you're driving down the road or what, and raised your eyebrows. What? An American classic, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn? Because some of the school board members in this Philadelphia school district want to be so politically correct that they scoured the books and they said The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn is not going to be read in our school system because it contains what we think is a racial slur. Now, there might be some of you people out in the audience that go, well, that's good. They should ban that if there's a racial slur. They don't want to offend anybody. Well, cut the garbage. That amounts to nothing more than censorship against our First Amendment rights in this country. And I pose the question to you, audience, where do they go from there? Where do they go from there? If they're going to ban an American classic, The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, are they going to next look at the bookshelf and say, let's ban the Bible? Think about it. Political correctness, or in this case, just plain downright in the dirt, dirty censorship. Kind of reminds you of what happened long time ago in Nazi Germany. Calls are welcome, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Come on, don't leave me hanging. You're the best audience in the world. Give me a call. Want to remind you about, speaking of the best audience, I know the best doggone auto body and repair shop, and that is Snake River Auto Body and Paint. Wow, do they do a great job. They're located at 404 4th Avenue West in Twin Falls. I took my truck in there after a lady decided to arrange the outside exterior, and they did a wonderful job, very good job. Satisfaction guaranteed. They're open 7 in the morning to 6 p.m. in the office, 8 to 1 on Saturdays, and I'll guarantee you they really know their business. Please take my advice and my recommendation for anything you need that's needed to be fixed on your vehicles, dings, dents, whatever, paint job, Snake River Auto Body and Paint. 404 4th Avenue West in Twin Falls, 734-5790. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Yeah, my problem is, as far as I know, they still have a banned Catcher in the Rye, and that's one of the worst books out there, considered a classic, and no child should be reading that book.
Why do you say, wait a minute, no child? What's the definitive statement there as to ages, and if it's in the school library, why do you discern that no child should be reading that book?
It's about a New York druggie.
Okay. So you think
and,
that...
And these kids my ideas. We had a grandson here a few years ago, and he wouldn't read it.
Okay. Where do you...
It was a required book.
Okay. Where do you discern...
I don't know if it's still in there or not at Minico, but, you know, if all the problems they have around here... That's one book that they don't need on their shelf.
Well, let me ask you this. How are you going to discern what is American literature that can be read or not, and how would you set up a list?
Well, I think some of these teachers need to go back and read some of the books they recommend. I don't know that they've all read them.
All right, so if you start talking about Daniel in the Bible and Bathsheba, are you going to ban that book also?
No, because, I understand what you're saying, but, it's a different situation.
I meant to say
it's
David.
It gets considered, Catcher in the Rye doesn't even make sense to most of these kids.
Right. By the way, I meant to say David, not Daniel. Thank you very much for your patience with me. But think that we're on a...
not be banned, and yes, we are headed towards the whole Nazi thing. Get rid of our guns, get rid of our money. Get rid of good literature and rule us, which you and I both know that's where we're headed.
Well, I appreciate your call. I appreciate your call.
Look at what happened with this gal in San Bernardino. They wouldn't go into her social media to find out who and what she really was because it isn't right. She doesn't have that was set up for the Americans, not for people trying to come in here from foreign countries, not for the immigrants. You know, they, until we know who and what they are, they shouldn't have the right to come into America.
Well, stop you for a minute. Just a minute. Well, let me get a word in edgewise here. Where do we draw the line on our safety and our security, and why does this administration afford the same American rights to people that are not citizens? They're basically saying, oh, we're not going to check on these people. We're not going to be embarrassed. We're not going to be non-politically correct. Hey, they check on us. Why are they giving them a lax attitude to get into this country?
That's what I'd like to know. You tell me, why are they? Why do they have more rights than we have as Americans? More income, more support to get started, financial support, you know, every direction, than we in America.
Yeah.
You know, that built this country.
Well,
and I don't know why they're giving them more rights than we have. They don't want to be embarrassed. Well, look what they just did. Now they found out they're being sued. Because they found out what this gal had written on all of her social media years ago against America, and that she was for ISIS.
Well, I thank you very much for your call, and have a merry, merry Christmas. Thank you very much.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Bye.
You know, I guess the way I would sum it up is this. There were great literary books that were on the reading lists at high schools ever since I was back in high school. That's when they still circled the wagons at night for protection. And I do not feel like I am qualified as a literary, critic, if you will, to say, well, this is bad, this is good, etc. I don't want to be in that position. I think I got to check this call. It might see. I'm kind of camped out alone here this morning. Old Deanne, there we go. Thank you so much. But I am not a literary critic, and I don't feel that I am capable of saying, "Oh, there's a bad part of this book, yeah, on page 203, that I don't think anybody should read while they're in high school. So that book should be banned." When you turn on the 6 o'clock news at night and listen and see the absolute chaos that is going on in our society, I fail to realize that reading a book is going to add to the misery. As a matter of fact, by reading a book, it might show a committed personality of someone trying to do better for themselves and better their situation. Instead of just standing out on the street corner going, hey, man, what do you got in your pocket? You know, this kind of an attitude. But I hate to think that we're going to turn into a society that says you can't read this. You will have to burn that or throw that book away. Because I revert again back to the Bible. Are they going to say that in the Old Testament, can't read that. Oh, boy, that might make somebody go to war. No. And in the New Testament, like Romans 1:27, they're going to go, oh, well, that's anti-gay. We've got to stop that. We've got to throw this Bible away. There's a lot of consequences for starting a censorship program. And I personally hope it doesn't happen. Calls are welcome, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Come on, give me a call. I think what I'm going to do is do the weather and then take some more of your phone calls. I want to talk to you about something that happened on our program yesterday and that we talked about. And then overnight, the whole situation flip-flopped for the better. For the better. So stay tuned for that. Right now it's time for the weather, brought to you by Mad River Laser. Hello, Nicole. Holy buckets, they've got everything over there for your home decor items for Christmas. I got to get over there this week. I'm trying hard to arrange my schedule so I can get over there. They've got all your abilities for your year-end award plaques for your business in acrylic, wood, trophies, everything. Oh, she does a wonderful job. And, of course, all your business promotional products. Oh my goodness, just please stop in and browse and look, and you'll be so impressed with the professionalism at Mad River Laser, 502 East Street in Rupert. And right now, here's Gina with the weather.
Here's your weather forecast as we are inching our way closer towards Christmas, but we still have about 11 days left. Looks like partly cloudy skies for today, slightly breezy winds out of the southwest, right around 14 miles an hour, high of 28 for today, tonight, low of 21. Tomorrow, expecting some afternoon snow showers, about a 50% chance, still going to be windy out of the west, about 15 miles an hour, high of 30 with an overnight low of 23, cloudy and 33 for Thursday, and partly cloudy and 40 for Friday. Yesterday's high was 31. The overnight low was 27. That's your weather for Zebeth Rain.
Thank you very much. Brought to you by Mad River Laser, 502 East Street in Rupert. Really nice folks. Come on, it's your turn. Give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Remember yesterday, excuse me for choking, I apologize then. Remember yesterday, I was talking about a New York school principal that made it an edict out of her office that there would not be Merry Christmas said in the halls, that there would not be anything about Santa Claus. Caller, I'll be right with you. Bear with me just a minute. Or there would not even be the saying of the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, buckaroos and buckarettes. Something happened yesterday. The superintendent of that particular school district came into the school and took over and told the principal, you sit down, you keep quiet. And this superintendent went and got two students out of class, and over the speaker system, the way it was given to me this morning, they stood there and gave the Pledge of Allegiance. God bless that superintendent. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Going back to your previous caller, there was a little confusion on what's going on with some of our... Well, there was lots of terms used. I thought maybe I'd introduce you to the latest term that I read about over the weekend, and that is our undocumented citizen. Now that isn't that nice?
Yeah. You know,
what a contradiction of terms.
Wait, stop a minute. Whoa. What in your terminology, what in the world is the common sense or lack of trying to refer to as immigrants undocumented? What kind of common sense is this?
Well, this isn't even immigrants. Immigrants are people that are coming here through our legal process.
That's
We're
right.
We're talking about illegal.
That's right.
They can put any kind of shoe polish on that they want. You know, a turd is still a turd. And that's what this thing is. And we keep letting the media tell us and redefine for us. And the liberal, unfortunately, that's where this is coming from. They keep redefining everything to make it seem innocuous and make us feel like we're somehow not sympathetic or whatever. Well, I'm not buying it. And I don't think half of America is either.
You know, I got to tell you. I got to tell you something, right? I don't mean to sound rude and interrupt you, but you're making some really good points, and I want to jump in on those various points. When I read that editorial in the Times News the other day about that one paragraph, and I had it on my program last week, to where basically they were referring to me and other people as blowhards and bigots and hate mongers because we were questioning the refugee center and questioning the way they're bringing these people in, I absolutely call for everybody that has common sense and is very concerned for their family and their livelihoods to stand up and say, wait a minute, stop. We need to have verification because that mess in San Bernardino would have never happened had they really taken the time to study all the hate that these Muslim killers were trying to purport.
Well, that's right. That's where the hate's coming from. And you look no further than their playbook called the Quran. And this group of people is different because of the book they're following. And that's what gets left out of the equation. They're very specific on what they want to accomplish, and it's very specific on how they are able to accomplish that. And when you try to compare to Germans or you want to compare to any other nationality trying to come here, the thing that sets the Muslims apart is the Quran, and it is a war document. Sorry, folks, it's not anything peaceful about it. It's all about war.
Let me ask you this real quick, and then I've got to get a commercial break in here. But that Judicial Watch is suing the Obama administration over this refugee program. But the latter part of the story that I had this morning, and I'll read it again, and I want your response to this. For the cost of resettling one Middle Eastern refugee in the United States for 5 years, the United States could pay to support the resettlement of 12 refugees in their own environment in the Middle East. Give me your thoughts quickly.
Well, that just speaks to the insanity of our government. They never do what's best, well, especially with the son of a Muslim guy we've got in the White House now. But there's no surprise there. The agenda is to infiltrate America and take it over. That's what Obama is trying to get done.
And it's a hard argument not to listen to, and quite frankly, you had the nerve to say it, and I'm going to say it. With all this liberal slush puppy that's being spread all over the United States, these people are not responsible for their own words and their actions, and they're so absolutely committed to protecting the enemy, and I don't know why more people aren't standing up and crying wolf.
Well, they're afraid. Political correctness was introduced to us some years ago, and that's been a very effective tool of dumbing people down or making them ashamed or pushing back on those that will speak up. And that's another thing we have to turn on its head, is political correctness can take a hike.
Amen. Sir, may I wish to you and your family a Merry Christmas. Thank you very much.
Same to you and your listeners. Thank you.
Thank you. He told it like it is. And quite frankly, I think it was good to say it that way. I just don't understand why we're even considering, well, now we better not check into that. That might offend these people coming into the country. I don't care if they're offended. I don't care if they feel they've had their toes stepped on. Do you really? I mean, here's a bad guy. Or maybe in the case of this female Muslim killer, bad lady, that is posted on her Facebook that she absolutely hates us, America. And that she really was espousing the theories and the philosophies of jihad against us. Now, if that's posted on her Facebook, and we are timid or politically correct not to notice, whoa, wait a minute. This old gal might be against America. We better hold up on letting her have a passport and a visa to get into this country. But no. Let's just let her in so we don't embarrass her and we're not politically correct. And to the families of that tragic San Bernardino shooting, the 14 that were killed and the many, many, many that were injured. Maybe this all could have been avoided with common sense and the protection of us, the citizens of the United States of America. Give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. I would like to hear from you, so give us a jingle. While I'm doing this commercial, I will wait patiently for your call. Don't forget, too, your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. I am blessed, as I said. I've got the cream of the crop, the creme de la creme of sponsors and advertisers, and also a frog in my throat, excuse me. And I'd like to say thank you to all seven locations of your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. Oh, my goodness sakes, the very best in snow tires, the very best in studded tires, the very best in tire chains and tire wheels. They've got it all for you right there at your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. And I want to really brag on many, many, many of their tires, like the Ultra Z900, and it's an all-season design, 65 to 80,000-mile warranty. Ooh, that is a good tire for your passenger cars. You stop in and check it out today, along with the brake service and the front end alignments and the shocks and struts and the batteries. Oh, yeah. Lane and Rupert, Dave on Blue Lakes and Twin, Mike and Buell, Mike and Jerome, the Twist family and Paul, John on Poline in Twin Falls, and Randy on Overland in Burley, the best. Your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. You better believe it. You know, this deal with Bo Bergdahl, a couple of weeks ago, on a Wednesday, I sat here at this desk and I asked you, the audience, a question because I didn't have the answer either. What happened to the story regarding Bo Bergdahl? What happened to a deserter and also possibly traitor against his country? It was all hush, hush. And he was holding down a desk job in San Antonio. Well, holy cow, all of a sudden, the wheels of possible justice started to get oiled and start up again. And now Bo Bergdahl may be up in a court-martial, a general court-martial situation, to where he might face life imprisonment, or even though the chances of this happening are extremely remote, and I think in some terms that's unfortunate, he could also possibly have the death penalty swayed in his direction. He is up for desertion and the endangerment to his fellow troops and possibly consorting with the enemy. And I know a lot of you people, oh boy, I remember the last time we had this story on the air when it was really out in front of the press, a lady and a lady and a gentleman called me, oh, you got to leave Bo alone, he's an Idaho boy, let's just merely be thankful that he's free. Whoa, stop the bus, Gus. Why should we be thankful just because he's an Idaho boy? And why should we overlook what he allegedly may have done to not only be a person that deserted, but also endangered his fellow troops? I say go get him. I say if the charges are there and the evidence is there, and the truth is there, I honestly hope that they go get him to every point of the law. What are your thoughts? Give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Quick reminder, tomorrow we are going to be over at Denny's Restaurant, 611 Overland in Burley. Why? Well, it's our broadcast for Christmas. That's right. Merry Christmas at Denny's tomorrow, and that's from 8 to 11. We're going to have the Burley High School choir singing Christmas carols, and Ken Mort singing Christmas carols, and Santa Claus is going to be there. Door prizes, everything at Denny's Restaurant, 611 Overland in Burley. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Well, good morning, Justin.
Hi there. Hello.
You know, I don't know all the details with this, you know, what's going on with Bo. But there was an article in Friday's Times News, and I just, maybe it's because I've got a warped sense of humor, I don't know, but I kind of chuckled to myself as I was reading the interview with Bo about how he thought that being a private, nobody would listen to, so he decided to walk off post to make a statement about the corruption in the military. The young man is a deserter. We know the family. We've done a lot of fundraisers for when he was prisoner. People need to step outside the box and realize that he is a deserter. He deserves to be punished. He should not be made a hero out of all this. Look at all the lives, and it wasn't proven that there was lives lost because of him, but there was proof that people, when they were out on maneuvers, were looking for him.
Yeah. Donna, let me jump in here and say something quickly because we're running out of time. And everything you said is spot on. But, you know, the defense, his attorney is a guy by the name of Feidel, I think it is. And they are painting a picture that the guy, after a year or so's time, that Bergdahl is maybe a little bit lax in cognizant thinking upstairs. And they've painted this thing that he actually thought he was an action figure from a movie like Jason Bourne from The Bourne Identity. They've had plenty of time to conjure up these ridiculous statements, and I always look at it like this. If it walks like a duck, quacks like a duck, doggone it, Donna, it must be a duck. And if he deserted and endangered his fellow Army platoon mates, I say go after him with everything they can.
Oh, I'm right there with you. Like I said, he is a traitor. He's a deserter. And he, you know, back in the old days, they just shot him. You know, there wasn't any of this garbage of life imprisonment.
Yeah. Working at a desk.
As well as everything else.
Yeah. I totally agree with you, and I thank you for your thoughts, because I tell you, this story is going to be like a bad fruitcake at Christmas time. I'm afraid it's going to keep coming around for a long time.
I think you're right, sir. You guys have a wonderful day.
God bless you, Donna. Thank you very much. You are listening to Zebeth Ranch. Make sure you're hearing everything. Contact Mount Harrison Audiology for a hearing screening. Call 312-0957 today. We're going to take a little break, send it back over to the big boys at CBS. A couple of stories that we've got to follow, and we will be back in just a little bit. Don't go away. Merry Christmas. Oh, good morning. Welcome back. Hour number two, Zebeth the Ranch, with our major sponsor, your Magic Valley, Les Schwab Tire Centers, all seven locations serving you, along with some of our great advertisers like Western Waste Services.
From the canyons of the Snake River and all across southern Idaho, we're always sure to serve Western Waste
Western Waste Services. They've got a fantastic idea for you. Why don't you give the gift that'll keep on giving all year long? Give trash service gift for your aunts and uncles, grandmas and grandpas, whoever in your family, so that once a week they have their garbage picked up. It's gone. It's out of there. This is really a great idea. Call them today. Western Waste Services, 734-6969. And they wish to you and yours a very Merry Christmas. That's a great idea. Hey, don't forget, too, every morning we start the program off at 8:06 with the weather forecast, brought to everybody by Cheney Flooring and Home Design, 1228 Oakley Avenue in Burley. Look for the blue door, and they've got great Christmas gift-giving ideas for you. Gift certificates, oh my goodness, all your carpet and flooring, kitchen construction, home decor, whatever you need to make your house a home at Cheney Flooring and Home Design in Burley. Want to also mention, too, quickly before we get our guest on the air, about our dear friends at Hanson Mortuary, 710 6th Street in Rupert, and Joel Heward, the manager, his staff, the family, they all wish to you and your families a very Merry Christmas. Please, they want to wish you the very best also for a Happy New Year. And they want to remind you that if there is the passing of a loved one in your family, you don't have to just sit there and just absolutely be thrown into turmoil. Please give them a call. They will help with the highest ethical standards with unquestioned integrity. Hanson Mortuary, 710 6th Street in Rupert, 436-5636. Let's go to the phone lines right now, and a dear, dear friend on the program every week, and we say good morning to Golden, Colorado's Frosty Woldridge. How are you, Frosty?
Good morning, Zeb, and Merry Christmas to each and every person listening today. And I'm reporting to you from, let's just call it really white Christmas, snowing like crazy, Golden, Colorado at 8,000 feet. even the deer hung up there behind the evergreens because it is just a blowing.
Well, you had the same storm today that I think went through here yesterday, and it didn't touch all of southern Idaho, but we got hit with a pretty good lick of it, and we certainly hope that you're enjoying the Christmas season. And with that being said, Frosty, I want to start something off very, very serious here. You and I have talked about this on private phone calls and then also on this program, but right now this morning, knowing everything that's coming down the pike with the lack of Homeland Security investigations, lack of FBI being inquisitive about who these people are that are coming into our country, the lack of the State Department literally dropping the ball on these refugees and these Muslim killers in San Bernardino, we don't know nearly as much about the people that are coming into the country as Obama's administration wants us to think. Your thoughts?
You would be very correct. We cannot. It is impossible to verify the background of any immigrant out of Syria, certainly out of the Middle East, and all of Europe is paying the price for that. All of Europe right now is terrified in its own country and its own cities, in its own communities, because the next Paris, France, could happen anywhere. It almost happened in Brussels, Belgium, very quickly after the Paris, France killings, and they're terrified. And that's what terrorism is, and that's how Islam operates. And the fact is that the Quran advocates for violence in order to spread Islam to everyone. It's called Hijra. And as they seed these countries, they also seed them with violent intentions and violent actions of Islamists, because that's what they do. And it's not any kind of it's not an aberration. Islam is a violent religion. It's the world's most violent religion here in the 21st century. It has created more terror since 1972 at the Olympics than any other entity whatsoever, and certainly any other religion. And San Bernardino is simply part of the Fort Hood killings, the Boston Marathon killings, the beheadings in Oklahoma, the recruiting station right there in Chattanooga, Tennessee. These Islamic agents, whether moderate or otherwise, are part and parcel of Islam's, absolutely spreading itself by the sword or by violence. And we're going to see more of it. And as you all have read in many of my columns, in fact, the one today is titled, and you can go to newswithviews.com, America Losing Her Ethos, and Why Trump is Rising in the Polls and Rising in the Estimation of All the American People. And one of the reasons is because he would stand up and shut down the borders, which I have called for well over 4 or 5 months now. And the key is, if we don't shut down the borders, we are guaranteeing greater numbers of Muslims in our country. And as their numbers grow, Zeb, their violence grows, because they get to harbor more and more of their violent religious followers. And that's what we're facing, not only now, but there's definitely another San Bernardino in the months ahead.
Well, I just this morning was sent some notification that a group, and I know you know who these people are, called Judicial Watch, is suing the State Department for documents related to Barack Obama's refugee and resettlement program. And here was something that really was interesting in the quote that came out from Judicial Watch, and I want you to respond to this. Quote, the Obama administration doesn't want Americans to know about how it places refugees from terrorist states in their local communities. The fact we had to file a federal lawsuit to obtain basic information about Obama's dangerous refugee plan should tell Americans and Congress that the Obama administration has something to hide about refugees, terrorism, and national security. Woo! Respond to that.
Well, and Judicial Watch is really outstanding in their ability to uncover the realities that we're facing. And if anyone of you really listening today has read the Dreams of My Fathers, this book. He's actually written two books. But the one thing that Barack Obama said in his book was that when the political winds turn ugly, I will stand with the Muslims. I don't know how anybody can not appreciate the fact that Barack Obama is a Muslim. That's no longer a doubt. He was masquerading as a Christian in a church in Chicago under a Pastor Wright for 20 years. And, of course, you all know that Pastor Wright just said, GD America. He condemned America. He did everything in his power to literally stand against America and the United States of America and the Constitution of America, the freedom of America. And Barack Obama sat there all those years absorbing all of that hate against America. And finally, of course, if you've seen any of the pictures of Barack Obama, he bows to Saudi princes. He bows? Who in their right mind would bow to a Saudi Arabian prince when the Quran over there keeps women's rights down to the level of a dog or less, kills people for honor killings, simply gay killings is automatic, you name it. And this man, this Barack Obama, bowed to a Saudi prince. What he's bowing to is Islam, because that is his religion. And we are now being the recipients for the next just 12 and a half more months, folks, 12 and a half more months, to this man who has no identification with America, and he's doing everything he can to obfuscate and completely cloud the real issue here, and that is Muslims in America and how they're literally usurping our culture and usurping our laws. And we're going to pay a severe price for this.
When you look at the, and I hate to use this terminology because I think there's something more sinister, but when you look at the naive, clueless, and arrogant way that this president protects the enemy and makes excuses for them, it's, you got to be blind, deaf, and dumb not to understand that there's got to be a reason as to why he's protecting them more than he is protecting us.
Well, because he's a Muslim, and Muslims are thicker than blood. They will always stand together. And even if you appreciate the fact that Muslims will fight amongst themselves, they'll kill each other, whether it's the Kurds, whether it's the Sunnis, whether it's the Shia, you know, whether, you know, you can go into any and all the different sects of the Muslims, the Palestinians, you know, really none of them really like each other because they have all these different interpretations. But the same interpretation runs through all of them, and that is to convert or kill all non-believers. And that is what the Muslim Quran and the Islamic Prime Directive manifests. And it's literally, and they're, of course, as you know, they're outbreeding Europeans. I mean, they're having 6 to 8 kids per woman, and each man has 4 wives. So the Europeans, whether it's the Germans or the UK or the Norway, they don't stand a chance against the breeding rates of Muslims. And so in the end, Islam will literally, if there's not a tremendous internal civil war and they forcibly force out all Muslims, they're going to be taken over by Islam. And we are going to see more caliphates in our own country, starting with Detroit, Michigan, Fremont, California, Minneapolis, Minnesota. You're already seeing this happen. In fact, I think it was in Maryland just last week, the Muslims dictated to a school that they would not have Merry Christmas, and they cannot have Merry Christmas because it offends them. Well, everything about America offends Muslims. Why they wanted to move here, of course, to disrupt us is, of course, again, you can go to the Refugee Resettlement Watch .wordpress.com and get the latest on that, is because they're here to literally turn America into an Islamic nation.
I've got another fact about this Judicial Watch story that I want you to comment on. But Frosty, I got to get a quick commercial break in here. Stand by. Merry Christmas wishes from Joe Taylor, 1826 Overland in Burley, with Carrie and Adams Real Estate. One call does it all, to 678-9400. He is the best, and he wishes you a very Merry Christmas from Joe. Joe Taylor. K&R Rental, 256 South 600 West of Burley. Number to call, 678-3122. And K&R Rental has it all, too. I mean, from all the lawn and garden equipment, all the way to the tractors, compressors, you name it. Whatever your project, they can help you. K&R Rental, Merry Christmas. And our friends at Haskin Insurance Services, 629 Fremont Street in Rupert. Number to call, 436-4141. These are really nice folks that understand insurance and can help you. Haskin Insurance Service, Merry Christmas. Frosty, at the bottom of this notification that I was sent by Judicial Watch, something very interesting I wanted you to comment on. They have studied the costs to you and I, the American taxpayers, and what this refugee resettlement program is going to cost us, America. And listen to this. For the cost of resettling one Middle Eastern refugee in the United States for 5 years, the United States could pay to support the resettlement of 12 refugees in their environment in the Middle East. We are being robbed.
We're not only being robbed, we're being scammed. I read that same article from Judicial Watch. Just to bring them over here is $55,000. Folks, if you, and that's just the beginning. One of the things about all of these refugees is they will be on the welfare doles. They will be on our tax dollar, our taxpayer backs, and it doesn't stop. These people they have no ability to function in a first world country. They come from a third world country. And so they have no skills whatsoever. They certainly can't speak English. They can't do. They literally can't do anything other than drive a cab, attend the store as a cashier. Past that, they can't do anything. And so they will be on food stamps. They will be on Section 8 housing. But take that just to start, $55,000 just to get them over here. And then start adding 250,000 Syrian refugees, which is the number that we are at this point being pledged by the UN to take into this country. You're going to see that this is going to cost us trillion. I don't know, it could be trillion or trillions of dollars. I mean, these days, I don't know how you figure out what a trillion is, but we're already $20 trillion in debt as a national debt in this country. And so all this is going to do is create even greater financial crisis for all Americans, and we're going to be carrying all of these refugees on our taxpayer backs, and it's going to, at some point, Zeb, you know and I know, you keep overextending your credit card, and you can't pay it at some point, then everything collapses, and you lose everything. Well, our country is going to lose everything, too. And what's sickening about this is Qatar and Saudi Arabia. There's you can see it on my Facebook page, Frosty Wooldridge. There's an entire, I think it's something like 20,000, 30,000 tents in a complete city for refugees, but they won't take them there in Saudi Arabia because they're terrified themselves of the kind of violence that they will commit there in Saudi Arabia. And so instead, we get the kind of violence here in the United States like San Bernardino.
You know, Frosty, I wasn't going to stay on this subject. I was going to ask you some other. But, you know, you and I, basically the same age, and we've talked and been friends for many, many years. I do not feel safe in this country. I do not feel safe if I had to get on an airplane. I do not feel safe sitting in an airport. I do not feel safe going to a major mall or gathering of people. And the feeling is that the terrorists have created that feeling. They have now created a feeling and instilled a feeling in us that they're out there and they're going to harm us. And our government, led by this very sinister Obama, has done nothing to belay those fears.
Well, he hasn't. In fact, he has exacerbated them. One of the reasons the Americans right now are absolutely are ready to vote anybody in but a regular career corrupt politician is because we are literally in our own country led by those who would literally undermine our countries, leading off with Barack Obama. You know, and here's one of the things. Liberals ask for tolerance of Muslims in Western countries and in America. They seem to think that we citizens in our own country can be expended as terrorist attacks escalate. We become the collateral damage for political correctness. The fact is, Islam advocates violence throughout the Quran. It's their prime directive. Yes, let's have tolerance for more Charlie Hebdo Muslim slaughters, or Paris, France Muslim slaughters, or the Fort Hood Muslim slaughters, or the Boston Marathon Muslim slaughters, and of course the San Bernardino Muslim slaughters, and who's going to be next? And it could be you or it could be me, because we're losing literally our country to Muslim immigration. And this horse feathers of radical versus moderate, no, they're all Muslims, and in the end, as their numbers grow, they all become radical and they demand everything. And I'm looking here right now at this latest report. Muslims forced Maryland school to ban Christmas because it insulted them. That's what we're facing right now. We're literally being undermined by this unbelievably violent religion, and no one is standing up to stop it except for Donald Trump. You know, and that's the crisis we're facing right now. And too many Americans just won't do anything. At some point, you either get out there and vote for a man who's going to stand up for this country, or your country and you will become a victim of this horrible immigration invasion of our country, especially with Muslims.
I think if I were to classify my fears right now as top priority or second in priority, I've got to say this. Yes, I am very concerned for my family, my friends, my neighbors, my audience, and their welfare. However, not so much with the fears of terrorism, but I am afraid of the apathetic America that is letting this happen. The populace just doesn't seem to want to pick up a pitchfork and go to arms with lunacy that's leading this country.
Well, that's correct. Americans are still apathetic. And the reason for that is because San Bernardino is not in their particular city.
That's right.
And all of us who don't have Muslims in our midst feel safe. But in the end, we are not safe, because these people are driven by an ideology, a religion, a political system that actually is outlawed, is in 1952 was outlawed by Congress. And why we're allowing it to still come in here, again, is because of the apathy. Not enough Americans are standing up or speaking out. They're afraid of being called names. And remember that one lady, I think, on the San Bernardino, she didn't call in Muslims that were living in the apartment building taking all these boxes in because she didn't want to be appear to be a racist. She was politically correct, and a whole bunch of people died. Well, that's you just magnify that across the country. Again, we're going to see more Islamic terror here in the United States, because that's how they operate, and that's what we're going to become victims of until we stop immigrating and importing all of these Muslims into our country.
Amen.
It's going to get worse, not better.
Amen. Frosty Wooldridge, Golden, Colorado. Time goes by too fast. Thank you, my dear friend, and to you and your lovely wife, Merry Christmas, and we'll talk to you next week.
And a Merry Christmas to you and yours. Godspeed.
God bless. Thank you very much. Dear friend right there, Frosty Wooldridge in Colorado. Cold, snowy Colorado this morning, he said. Let's not forget our friends at Let's Ride, 270 Highway 24 between Rupert and the world. I mean, my goodness sakes. They've got all the four-wheelers. They've got all the snowmobiles. They've got all the snowplows for your four-wheeler. They've got some great gift-giving ideas for Christmas. Snowmobile clothes, 20% off, and they've got fantastic gloves to keep your little pinkies warm. Oh, my goodness sakes, save money and keep your hands warm on their fantastic gloves and X-brand goggles, 35% off, and select T-shirts and sweatshirts. Buy one, get one free. Wow, all of this and more at Let's Ride, Highway 24 between Rupert and the world. And yes, it's true, that is where the fun is sold. Also, if you're over on Highway 24, don't forget Cameron and Siemens Insurance, Highway 24 in Rupert. Life insurance, health insurance, retirement planning, employee benefits, everything you need to know about, and make sure you're covered for your security. You check with them. Very responsive and dedicated to your needs. Cameron and Siemens Insurance, Highway 24 in Rupert. And that number again, 436-4424. You call them today. Don't forget, tomorrow is the big day. We're going to be over at Denny's Restaurant, 611 Overland in Burley, for our old-fashioned Denny's Merry Christmas. Yeah, betcha, buddy. We're going to broadcast live and direct from there tomorrow. And it's going to start at 8 o'clock, go all the way to 11, and they're going to have specials on the menu, great food, Christmas carolers from the Burley High School Choir, door prizes, Santa Claus, Loot in the Boot, Ken Mort, all of this and more tomorrow at Denny's from 8 to 11, Zeb at the Ranch broadcast, and we will see you there. Hopefully, come on down. Real quick, Santa Claus has already been in this area. Why? Well, he delivered a lot of furniture specials for you, at least furniture, floors, and more, 459 Overland and Burley. Oh, my goodness. All the sofas, all the recliners and chairs, nothing better than a good, comfortable recliner to kind of kick back and enjoy life. And, of course, all the bunk beds and the sectionals and the dining sets, it's all there. All there with people that are the pros in furniture, Lee's Furniture, floors, and more at 459 Overland in Burley. You stop in and see them today. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, Zeb.
Yes, sir.
American people finally realize what a dud we've gotten in the White House. He's just an inactive guy, and we can blame all the problems we're having in Los Angeles on his inactivity.
I would say the entirety of the administration, they are absolutely not doing their job. I'm going to be highly critical of the next 400 days that we're stuck with this Obama and his administration, and I think it's going to get far, far worse. Tony, God bless you and Mary. Merry Christmas. I've got a guest waiting. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you.
All right, buddy. I'll take my guest on in just a moment. Don't forget, Red's Trading Post, 203 Fifth Avenue South in Twin Falls. Oh, my goodness. I want to remind all the people that are into reloading that Red's Trading Post has the hard-to-find powder for reloads at 203 Fifth Avenue South in Twin Falls. All your guns, Browning, Beretta, Weatherby, Ruger, Benelli, Smith & Wesson, and Winchester, all the ammo, all the accessories, plus all the people that really know firearms are working there to serve you at Red's Trading Post, 203 Fifth Avenue South in Twin Falls. We are going now to the telephone line, and we have a gentleman. I think he's been on this program before. I'll have to ask him. His name is Doug Sackleben, and he's with the Club for Growth. Good morning, Doug. How are you? Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. Thanks so much for having me on.
First and foremost, Doug, did I say your last name correctly?
It's not an easy one. Sackleben, yes. It's one of those that, you know, people just say all different kinds of ways, but you're on track.
What nationality is Sackleben?
It's a German. You know, that last part, that Leben, you know, it's kind of the German pronunciation is life. Now, what I've been told is the Sack part, and maybe one of your listeners that's got some good German background might correct me, but I've been told it's actually soft life, so... You know, it's just kind of casual, sort of kick back and play golf.
Okay, well, listen, now explain a little bit also, if you would, Doug, for the Club for Growth. What does that mean? What is that organization?
Yep, Club for Growth is about 100,000 members, one of the largest national groups of pro-growth fighters, the individuals who want to see our government limited in its effect on the free market. Lower taxes, less regulation, entitlement reforms, things that pull government out of the private sector and allow the free markets to run the best way possible. And so we fight for those policies and also for policymakers, for conservative pro-growth politicians who can come to Washington and lead on those sorts of tax reform kind of issues.
Okay. Big night tonight. I mean, man, if I were Donald Trump, I think I would get the feeling that I'm standing in the center of a circular firing squad. Would you agree?
I would, yeah. I think you're going to see some interesting battles on different fronts, because with Senator Cruz now having a lead, at least in the Des Moines Register poll in Iowa, I suspect he'll be a target as well, and so the two of them will be at maybe at each other to some degree, and then everybody else has got so much riding on this. For a lot of the candidates who are on the periphery of that group, this is make or break time now, and so they've got to take some shots at folks like Trump and even Cruz to try to get themselves moved to where they can at least stay on that stage and last into January.
Now, I'm going to say this, and you can correct me. You're the expert. I'm not. But, you know, I think it's ridiculous and almost an insult to our intelligence and our questioning minds as taxpayers to have 9 people still up on the stage. There are those that do not deserve to be there. There are those that are getting just a menial 2 or 3% of the popular vote right now, possibly, for these polls. I think, honestly, that it's a ridiculous waste of time and airtime of a lack of questions to have that many people on the stage. Correct me if you think I'm wrong.
No, I wouldn't. I agree with you. I think you're right, and I think it's a disservice, unfortunately, to the viewers who want to hear thoughtful answers and pushback. We don't want to see moderators so much debating candidates, but we want to see them be able to have time to follow up so that if you do get just a talking points answer, you can say, okay, now be specific. And unfortunately, this kind of format doesn't allow it, but it's something that we've thought from the beginning of this campaign in terms of campaign fundraising and the ability that candidates have, whether it be from a super PAC or otherwise, that there's that ability to hang in there longer, which for some, I know it's, you know, you're riding it out hoping for some kind of glimmer, but when you've got the 4-card undercard for members there who are battling, who nobody will be really paying attention to at this point, and then probably at least 3 or 4 on the main stage who are in single digits, very low single digits, it makes for a long night and not an opportunity for the leading voices to give the substantial answers that we should be hearing.
Doug, you study this stuff every day. Do you believe all these different polls? Do you believe all these different percentages? One poll I heard about this morning showed Trump at 41%. Others in Iowa, like you just suggested, show that Cruz is ahead of Trump. Honestly, do you believe all these polling numbers?
You know, the trick, I think, in these polling numbers that we don't often pay attention to, and certainly the headlines don't give credence to, is the difference between registered voters and likely voters and very likely voters, in the sense that the ABC poll, the one that you mentioned, the 41%, is registered voters, and I think if I recall the numbers correctly, about 35% of that pool of 1,000 or so people is Republican, and then the rest are Democrats and independents. So what that tells you is that Trump's got a broad appeal, but that doesn't really tell you much about Republican primaries, and even less about, say, the Iowa caucus on a cold winter's night, you know, in February, or the New Hampshire primary. And that's when you get down to, when you start polling likely and very likely, that's when you start to see Senator Cruz rise in a number of these. When you see people who've done this caucus system before or gone to primaries before, that's when some of the other candidates begin to rise, and that'll be the question for the Trump folks, is whether or not they can actually turn out the voters who seem enthused about him right now.
I really, and I say this, and a lot of people say, oh, come on now, Zeb, but honestly, I'd rather see the kid that washes the dishes down at the local restaurant run and win against Hillary than having another 4 years of an extended Obama program that could lead us to the complete road to ruin. What are your thoughts?
Zeb, I'll help you on supporting that kid if that's the case. I agree. It's you just got to meet the age threshold. He's going to have to be a little older, but nonetheless, you know what I try to remind people about when you start talking about that is how much influence is happening from our federal courts. Congress has, in many ways, is not as leading, is not as proactive on legislation, and maybe we want them to do less in some sense, but the federal courts are jumping in a very proactive way and making decisions and getting involved in legislation, and the argument that we conservatives often have is legislating from the bench. Well, that federal court system, that's appointees from the administration, and if 4 more years of what's essentially the Obama administration in the form of Hillary, we'll continue to stack those courts, will no doubt be Supreme Court nominees that will make the regulation coming out of Washington far more worse than it even is now. And it's hard to imagine that, but it would be.
Has the millennial vote in this country, or the potential of the millennial vote, and just absolutely an apathetic America in general, is that what has propelled and kept Hillary on top of the Democratic pile? She's a liar. She's a fraud. She's a charlatan. She's absolutely, I don't think, in any way, shape, or form qualified to be president of the United States. Why is she so popular?
Well, I mean, I think it's so interesting when you compare the Republican bench to the Democrat bench at this point. One of the things we saw coming into this cycle is the Republicans are bringing to the table one of the best benches, one of the best fleets of candidates that we've seen in a number of cycles. And you look across the aisle, and there's just pretty slim pickings at this point. I mean, the faces of the Democrat Party, once you take Barack Obama out of the picture, have been, what, Nancy Pelosi and Harry Reid, and those are certainly people who are despised by a fair number of Americans at this point for their policies and the way that they've done things. So you're left with, who do you have? I mean, who's your face? And I think there's still a lot of Democrats that somehow cling to the Bill Clinton days and the hope that this is somehow a revival, even though I don't think we can honestly see it that way. You're right about all the things you said about Hillary. She's a candidate who you wonder if she'll make it to Election Day without being indicted.
You know, let me ask you this, Doug, and again, you study this, and you're a great educator for me, but when you look at the liberal left and their platform of whether people like them or not, it doesn't make any difference. They're liberal, and they espouse kind of a no morality left with their stand on various subjects. Where do they get all their support? I mean, still, there's a lot of good people in this country that believe in God, believe in going to church, believe in family situations the way they should be. Where does the left get all of its support?
Well, I mean, you see it on those electoral maps, unfortunately. It tends to be the coast and the big cities. And certainly you question at some point what issues, because what they're appealing to in so many of these big cities is this notion of a $15 minimum wage that you and I, Zeb, know would be a job killer for your young people who have got the job at the fast food restaurant and who want, you know, the guy who runs that fast food restaurant knows that there's no way he can pay everybody $15 an hour and still somehow eke out a living. But it's that sort of appeal to those inner cities to say that somehow we'll get you more from the government. We'll force the private sector to do something that will benefit you. We'll step in because free enterprise isn't benefiting you. And instead of pushing opportunity, which we should be doing, they're pushing, this notion that government will just make everything right. And yet, again, you and I look at these inner cities and see so many of them are the places that are struggling with poverty and the crime, and they've had Democrat administrations. So I'm not sure ultimately what the selling point is there, but that's certainly the message they've been playing.
You know, Doug, looking at this election, and I've said I think that this election in 2016 is the most critical election ever for the history of the United States. We're either going to go down the trail to the left to the point of no return, or we're going to go to the right, we're going to make a lot of switches and try to restore the integrity and the morality of this country. Do you agree with that synopsis? This is very important.
I do, Zeb, and it's not overstatement. I know we've been saying it for the last few elections, but each one, I think, is building in significance because we're seeing the consequences. We're seeing in terms of people's health insurance, the cost that they're paying. We're seeing in terms of a largely stagnant economy. Now the questions and the Club for Growth doesn't focus as much on these issues of national security, but the questions of how safe the country is. All of these things are coming to a real crucial pivot point, and we're finding that the last 7 years have not made gains in any of those categories, and so to continue down that path, it is difficult. And as I said before, the federal courts, it's difficult to imagine somebody actually being able to come in and turn that ship around if it continues down the path.
I want to go back to Donald Trump in the remaining time on this interview, Doug, and I want to ask you this. You know, there was a lot of push to have Donald Trump stand up in front of TV cameras and pledge his allegiance to the Republican Party and sign a pledge. Now that same Republican Party is doing every single thing they can to throw him under the bus. Boy, it doesn't seem like it's going to be a fair shot for this man one way or the other.
You know, there's two ways I think that when you approach a candidate that you disagree with, you either do the kind of stuff that unfortunately that what we saw in the news report with the party holding this behind closed doors meeting and trying to figure out how you manipulate things in your direction, which is foolish and just it alienates people, and it also takes the notion that you can somehow change outcomes of elections, which is the last thing that people want to hear. Or if you disagree with the candidate, then you state where your disagreement is, and you show where that candidate stands. I mean, that's the Club for Growth has not been a fan of Donald Trump by any stretch, but what we've tried to focus on is say, listen, the guy's been all over the map on issues, and we seriously question where he is on taxes and health care and those sorts of things. I think it's one thing to say about your opponent. These are the positions that we question and we have serious concerns about, as opposed to what we're hearing about some of this backdoor stuff, that backroom stuff that people do not want happening. That's the kind of stuff that just builds up a candidacy like his.
With his brashness, his bluntness, his arrogancy, and in many cases a display of being the tough guy instead of really being the knowledgeable guy, can Trump win the nomination, and better yet, can he win the presidency, or will the American public at the last second say, oops, and go the other way?
That's, you know, there is the question. I mean, the question that I think if you had asked me that, I know what my answer would have been back in June when he announced as a candidate. No, this isn't going to go to a nomination. It's about a brand exercise. And here we are now in December, and the polls present a different story. I still think, going back to what I said earlier, I do think when you look at likely caucus goers, I think he's got still a tough battle in Iowa. I think you're going to still see a lot of evangelicals turn out. And Ted Cruz is, I think, poised from that Des Moines Register poll to still have a good night there. But it's, what, 5-6 weeks at least ahead, so anything could happen. The question about the general election, it's so hard to predict at this point, because he's had such an interesting draw across the board and yet has said things that so alienate some people. You could see it going down two different, totally different paths, either being the worst thing in the world for the Republican Party or, you know, could surprise us all. At this point, I'm not one who wants to take a chance. I think folks like Ted Cruz and some of the others have shown a good record and would be good, reliable conservatives that would be good leaders.
You know, let me ask you this final thought, Doug. Right now, of course, the news media and, of course, those illustrious polls are showing that the front runners are Bush, or pardon me, they're Trump and they're Cruz and Rubio and Carson, and Bush way down at best 5%, at most 4%. Is there any way that there will be an awakening of the supporters for Jeb Bush, or is he a horse they ought to put back in the barn?
I think when you look at some of the stories, I think his close supporters have been fighting for him as hard as ever, even to their own detriment at times, and going after Rubio in some of the ways they have, and not focusing on their own candidate. But I just don't think the voters have bought what Jeb Bush is telling. There's some unfortunate aspect to it. If people are willing to go back and look at how he governed Florida, there was certainly some good conservative leadership that he provided, particularly on economic issues. But in terms of being a candidate in 2015, the message has not been inspiring, and it's not convinced people that he won't be a big government kind of solutions guy. And they just haven't seen the sort of outsider conservatism that they're really looking for. So I don't imagine, even if he had a big night tonight, which I don't think we've seen in any of the previous debates, that it would make a whole lot of difference.
Okay. First of all, let me extend to you and your family a very, very Merry Christmas. And we've been visiting with Representative for Club for Growth, Doug Sackleben. And thank you. God's blessings. And please come back soon.
Zeb, I'll be happy to do that. Merry Christmas to you and your family as well. Thanks so much for having me on.
All right, sir. Thank you very much. Very informative gentleman right there, Doug Sackleben, with the Club for Growth, and talking about not only the debates tonight going on in Las Vegas for the GOP, but also politics in general. And I really appreciate his remarks this morning. Holy smokes, it's time for the weather, and it's also time for you to give me a call. I've got time for some extra phone calls at 436-224. 1-866-927-4587. Weather brought to you this hour by Mountain Transmissions. We're going to be talking to Rick Martin later on this morning, as a matter of fact, and finding out a little bit more about his business, now serving all southern Idaho. Mountain Transmissions, all makes and models, cars, trucks, RVs, motorhomes, 4x4s, foreign and domestic, repairs, rebuilds, clutch repair. My goodness, they know transmissions. And they're located at 504 East Main in Burley. The number to call when you're having a little transmission trouble, 678-9110. Mountain Transmissions now brings you Gina with the weather.
Here's your weather forecast as we are inching our way closer towards Christmas, but we still have about 11 days left. Looks like partly cloudy skies for today, slightly breezy winds out of the southwest, right around 14 miles an hour, high of 28 for today. Tonight, low of 21. Tomorrow, expecting some afternoon snow showers, about a 50% chance. Still going to be windy out of the west, about 15 miles an hour, high of 30 with an overnight low of 23. Cloudy and 33 for Thursday, and partly cloudy and 40 for Friday. Yesterday's high was 31. The overnight low was 27. That's your weather for Zebeth Rand.
Great job. Thanks, Gina. And brought to everybody this hour by Mountain Transmissions. Huh, you put it in drive and didn't go anywhere, huh? Well, you better have your transmission checked and repaired at Mountain Transmissions. They're located at 504 East Main in Burley. And the number to call, 678-9110. All right, give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. I'd like to hear from you. By the way, congratulations to Dot Foods in Burley. Dot Foods was awarded the 2015 State of Idaho Award in Industrial Efficiency. And as I was reading the story this morning, I found out more. Each year, the Idaho Governor's Office of Energy Resources recognizes industrial companies that are exceptional state leaders in implementing energy efficiency at their local facilities, and congratulations to Dot Foods for winning that award in Burley. Congratulations. A quick note here that I need to get on. The Cache County School Board is going to have a meeting tomorrow night at 7 p.m. at the Cache County School District office at 3650 Overland in Burley, and that starts at 7 p.m. tomorrow evening. Don't forget that. Caller, good morning. You're on the air.
Yeah, good morning, Zeb. I can never hardly hear you, but I'd like to make an announcement of a meeting tonight in Twin Falls at CSI at the Taylor Building, room 277. There will be a meeting on supporting our local police and keeping it independent.
Absolutely.
A PowerPoint presentation starts at 7 o'clock, no admission charge. And, you know, Obama, in addition to all the other things he's doing about bad about our country, obviously wants a national police force and take away our local police. And I would encourage people that are interested to come out and find out more about this drive that's going on and how we can keep our police independent. Realizing, you know, not all policemen are perfect, they make mistakes, but we see the attack is unbelievable nationwide, as you have witnessed recently, Zeb.
And yeah.
So I would encourage people that tonight, 7 o'clock, CSI Taylor Building, that's right there, the main building on CSI campus at 7 o'clock, upstairs in room 277 in the Taylor Building.
All right, now, Adrian, listen to me very carefully here and give me a short answer because I'm almost out of time this hour. There are people, that you know, there are people that I know that really are not keeping themselves informed, and they say, oh, good, a national police force. They think it's a good idea. I want you, in a very short 60-second dissertation, tell me and everybody else why this is very sinister and very scary.
Well, if you like the KGB, if you like the Gestapo tactics of Hitler, those are two good examples and two good reasons right there why we do not want a national police force.
Absolutely.
And, of course, that situation nationwide, every country that's given up their local police to a national police force, the citizens sooner or later lose their freedoms And our sheriff, of course, is the most important elected official. So don't overlook that. In all the counties around the area here, you've got to have a sheriff that's going to stand up for you. He's the last line of defense between you and the federal government.
Absolutely.
Come in, and he just bows down like the Republicans have to Obama, then we're in big trouble.
Absolutely.
We need to really camp on those sheriffs and keep them independent.
All right, Adrian, I appreciate your comments, and especially that reminder. It's tonight at 7 p.m. at room 277 of the Taylor Building at CSI. Support your local police. Thank you very much.
Yep, keep them independent.
All right, sir.
Bye now.
All right, take care. Very good point. You do not want a knock on the door from a national Gestapo force. Nobody does. This is America. Merry Christmas wishes from Clark's for Shopping at 100 East Main Street in Oakley. These are wonderful people, and they've got that famous Clark's famous breakfast sausage in bulk patties or links. Ho, my grandma's recipe. Merry Christmas from Clark's for Shopping in Oakley. And Merry Christmas from Riverview Urgent Care Center. They've got locations at 382 North Overland in Burley, 133 West Avenue A in Jerome, and a brand new one coming to Twin Falls. Kyle and the rest of the folks from Riverview Urgent Care Center say Merry Christmas. And our buddy Scott Gonneau of Gonneau Landscaping, oh my goodness, they do a wonderful job. Scott Gonneau, 336 South, 450 West of Hayburn. Number to call and remember, 438-2485. Wishing you and yours a very Merry Christmas. I love Christmas time. Oh, ring those bells, by the way. Hey, I want to get this in. I know I might forget, and I don't want to do that, that our dear friend Joe Taylor is going to be celebrating his 90th birthday, I understand, and maybe also his wife, the way that this advertisement was written. It says, happy 90th birthday, Joe and Ethel Taylor. Oh, my goodness. 90 years young. They are the sweetest people I know, and they're going to have a special gathering at the Golden Heritage Senior Citizen Center on Friday, December 19th. No, Saturday, December 19th. Whew, get that right. From 2 to 4, so don't forget that. Congratulations, Joe and Ethel Taylor. And the dog's barking, and we got to tell everybody real fast that you've been listening to Zebeth Ranch, and Ruby's all upset. Make sure you're hearing everything, including the dog bark. Contact Mount Harrison Audiology for a hearing screening. Call 312-0957 today. Really, really nice people. Ruby, be quiet, please. Coming up next hour, we've got Dr. History with Dr. Ken Turner. And then at 10:30, we're going to be talking to Rick Martin with Mountain Transmissions. And at the end of that half hour, a very special story. So I want you to tune in, please. Zebeth Ranch right here on KBAR, 1230 AM, and streaming live all over the universe, zebbell.com. Maybe we could have old Wheels play a little Christmas music as we head on up to CBS News Time. I'll be back in about 6 minutes. Don't go away. Oh my, here we go. Down the yellow brick road. The Wizard of Oz has a Santa Claus hat on. Good morning and Merry Christmas, Zeb at the Ranch. I'm Zeb Bell. And brought to you by our major sponsor, your Magic Valley Les Schwab Tire Centers. All 7 locations serving you. Along with some of our great advertisers, including Western Way Services. Always at your disposal, 734-6969. Oh, my goodness. Hey, don't forget the Chadwick Sports Grill. 139 West Main in Burley. And today, listen to this. This is a new one on our list of specials. Smoked Gouda, avocado, and turkey sandwiches. With choice of soup or salad. That sounds really good. Smoked Gouda, avocado, and turkey sandwiches. Oh, sink your grinners into that at the Chadwick Sports Grill, 139 West Main in Burley. Great food, great people at the Chadwick. You stop in and see them today. By the way, on Thursdays, we have a program segment called, of course, Cache County School Days. And we want to thank our sponsors real quick. Child's World at 1308 Overland and Burley. Oh, my goodness. They've got everything for you for Christmas. Toys, games, puzzles, clothing, everything at a Child's World, 1308 Overland in Burley. And the Ambulatory Surgery Center at 1344 Highland in Burley. Number to call. Save money on your outpatient surgeries, 677-8888. Get a hold of them today. Ambulatory Surgery Center. And, of course, a Child's World bringing you school days in Cache County on Thursdays. Good heavens, look what time it is. It's time for Dr. History. And Dr. History is brought to you by Minnacashia Sales, 1321 East Main Street in Burley, right across from the airport with Zach and the rest of the crew. My goodness, windows. My goodness, shingles. My goodness, lumber. Oh my goodness, they've got everything for you right there, including all the Tartar Farm and Ranch panels and gates. Everything with Minnacashia Sales. You stop in and see them today. And you can probably hear him breathing in the background into his microphone. Here is now the world famous, and I mean that, in 110 countries, Dr. History.
Good morning, Zeb. How you doing today?
I'm fine. Did you do your homework?
No, but I did something else.
Oh, okay.
So we've still got a show here.
All right, what do you got?
All right, well, last week we talked about Geronimo.
Yeah.
From his standpoint, so to speak, or from the historian's standpoint, but this is a story about a young man who had a very close relationship with Geronimo, and it is told in the first person by himself and recorded by one of his relatives. So the story is going to be in his words, first person, and I put a lot of credibility into this because it's not somebody else's interpretation of what happened.
Okay, now this person that had the story and basically gave the information for the story, he was kidnapped as a young child in Mexico, is that correct?
Yes.
By Geronimo?
Yes.
Okay.
So I'm just going to tell it as he told it. So
okay.
He says, I felt the hot, wet belly of Geronimo against my back as I was snatched from the prairie grass where I was herding my father's calves in Magdalena, Sonora, Mexico. You've been there, Zeb.
I know where it is.
Okay,
yes.
And thrust in front of him on his spotted pony. It all happened so fast that summer day in 1869 that I did not have time to heed the warning that my mother had given to me. Run like the wind when and if you hear a coyote. Do not stop for calves or anything else. Just run for home. Well, he says, I knew that Geronimo could imitate a coyote so well that even a coyote wouldn't know the difference. But this time he fooled me. And when I heard the cawing of the crows, I was not prepared for Geronimo, who had been raiding into Mexico ever since the Mexicans had been accused of killing the chiefs. And as they call him a chief, but
yeah.
We talked last week, he never was a chief.
He never was a chief.
No.
No.
But he'd been accused of killing Geronimo's entire family, his wife, with all of his children.
Right.
Now, he says, I had heard this tale many times as we sat eating tortillas and frijoles at our table. This had happened sometime in 1858. I was born about 2 years later.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here I was, 9 years of age, a small Indian boy, paying for something that the Mexicans did before I was even born.
So this is around 1860?
Right.
Okay.
Yes. It was dark, without a moon, when we rested and ate food that my captor provided, tortillas and frijoles from a tall tin can. I was tired and I was worried. I was worried about what my mother would be thinking or doing. My father would be more worried about the 10 calves and perhaps miss them more than he would me.
Hmm.
So kind of gives you an idea of what his dad was like.
Yeah, not a very close family.
Yeah, he says, I tried to understand this. I thought of Maria, my little sister, who was about 10 months old. There was a breeze, and Geronimo wrapped a red blanket around me. I slept fitfully and was awakened very early and told to hurry, as the sun would be hot before long. I choked down another cold tortilla and was helped upon Geronimo's pony again. When daylight came, I was out of my small world into strange country.
Right.
It was what I was later to be the state of Arizona. I was delighted with the big jackrabbits, which the other Indians brought down fast. Now, the sun was hot. We rested many times. We had ample water and food. I saw the big chief staring at me continuously. Then he spoke to me in the very language that I spoke of, Spanish or Espanol. It is difficult, and here's what Geronimo said, is that it is difficult to tell the difference among the people of Mexico, he said. There are the Mayas, the Opatas, and the mixed ones, those with the Spanish in their veins. Which one are you, son? Well, he says, I guess that all Indians know their tribe, and I told him I was Opatai. And I hope I'm saying that right.
Yeah.
I hope that it would be his day to like this tribe.
Uh-huh.
Well, the Greg Geronimo did a funny little dance that night, as he had promised me he would, if the moon would shine. There was a campfire, and I listened to the Braves tell weird tales before I fell asleep. I saw many head of cows, calves, and ponies being driven ahead of us. I tried to make out those of my father, but I could not. Geronimo shook me gently, and I knew that we were entering his camp. It was dark. He knew that he was wanted by the soldiers of the United States for his numerous raids. He'd been in and out of the garrison for years, but he was not afraid. The first night I slept beside him on the red blanket. I heard him say a prayer to the high power. I knew then that he was not too bad of a guy.
Stop right there, and let me ask you a question. Now, this young man was taken as a hostage or whatever for slavery?
You know, they did that for all things. Sometimes they would sell them. Sometimes they used them for a slave. Sometimes they just integrated them into the tribe. So I don't know how they decided who and which, what they were going to do.
I'll let you go a little bit, and then I got to break in for a commercial break.
Anyway, so he's laying next to him. He says, I know that he was not too bad. He took my hand and told me not to be afraid. This made me feel better, and I slept after saying a prayer myself.
Now, how old was this boy when he was taken?
He was 9 years old.
Oh, my goodness.
So why don't we go ahead and take a break now, Zeb? This would be a good spot.
All right. I want to remind everybody that we are blessed. Dr. History and I have talked about this many, many times. We're blessed with the sponsorship of this segment by Minnecashia Sales. Very nice people. Very knowledgeable people. And that's Zach and the rest of the crew at Minnecashia Sales, 1321 East Main Street in Burley. You don't know where it is? Let me tell you. It's right across the street from the Burley Airport. And they're open 8 to 4:30 Monday through Friday. And the number to call, 878-2091. I mean, we're talking carpet. We're talking vinyl. We're talking windows with the Western Windows. Keep the cold outside and the heat inside. We're talking all the Tartar Farm and Ranch gates and panels. We're talking about a business that has what you need. So please stop in and see them today at Minnecashia Sales, 1321 East Main Street in Burley. And they are the proud sponsors of Dr. History.
Okay. 1 month or so later, I had been taken. I was called to the chief. Now, again, he calls him the chief, but he never really was a chief. But I guess he looked at him.
Yeah, well, when you look at the circumstances, though, if he's the leader of that band, naturally there would be the assumption that he is, per se, the chief.
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So, and that's probably where that got started,
right,
because he was the leader. Anyway, he began calling me El Cativo. I wondered what he wanted with me. Cativo, he said, do you know what embers are? I answered him once, yes, chief, I know what they are. Do you know that in order to be brave and courageous that you must be tried by fire?
Oh, boy.
I could not answer this. I was fearful. Now you are full of fear, he said, but anger will replace fear after the trial by fire.
Uh-oh.
And you know what's coming.
I do.
I did not grasp.
He's got a real heavy pair of moccasins on.
He says, I did not grasp what he meant as he kept talking to me. When he left me, he patted my arm, and I knew that he liked me. Well, in about
Good. He's going to turn him into Joan of Arc, but he liked him, yeah.
So in about 3 days more, after the talk of the embers, I was called to him. I hate to hurt you, Cativo, he began, but what is about to happen will make a brave man of you. He tried to smile. Well, I was joined by about 10 other boys. Some were Apaches, others Cativos like himself. Now I was about to be tried by fire. I was ill and wanted to run anywhere. The sight that confronted me made me quake. I watched the others and saw that they were also afraid. Then we were forced by the Braves to walk on the glowing embers of fire.
You are making my deodorant wear off.
Oh, you know, I've heard of this, but...
I saw a movie, a Western movie with it, and quite frankly, I just didn't like that.
Yeah. Well, I shall never forget that terrible day.
Oh.
The fire was down in a pit. After several minutes of racing over the inferno, many boys fainted.
Wait a minute, you had to do it more than once?
Yeah, They were going back and forth.
Are you kidding me?
So many of the boys fainted, and they were hurried away to the Indian women who were waiting with herbs to treat the burns. I was suffering horribly, but I found that I was the only one left who had not fainted.
Uh-oh.
Then I was lifted bodily by Geronimo and rushed to a woman called Snake Woman who had great power.
Oh, this really is, that's going to make me feel better. Who's going to work on you?
Yeah.
Snake Woman!
Snake Woman. So Geronimo said, ease his pain at once, he demanded of her. And by some strange miracle, she did.
Well, come on.
My feet were dipped in a pottery bowl full of a cool liquid, and all pain stopped instantly.
Oh, my goodness.
I was never to learn the contents of the dish of Snake Woman. Although I had scars, I suffered little from the burns.
I wonder if she has an office in Twin Falls.
I don't know, but I'm thinking it had to be aloe vera. Just, you know, aloe vera is good for burns.
Really?
So I'm that's just my guess.
They knew all about that stuff.
They did, yes.
Yeah.
So anyway, Geronimo said to me, now let anger replace fear. It did. He said,
you went and wanted to kill Geronimo.
No. He said, we were forever hearing talk in Geronimo's camp about the soldiers of the United States government.
Oh.
Geronimo warned us several times, I shall be taken away for good one of these days. But between now and then, I will raid, and raid again. And as we talked last week, that's what he did.
Yeah, he did.
I lived as many Apache lived. I was one of them because I had been through the Blood Brother Rite in 1880 when I was 20 years old. So by now I'd been with him for 11 years. I was with Geronimo when he was taken prisoner. I went back with the others to mourn his capture. I guess he had somehow or another made us feel that he was an earth god.
So he was about 21 at that time.
Yeah, so you can see why they assumed that he was a chief, how highly they thought of him.
Yeah.
But anyway, it was not until he was back with us, but was one of the most wanted of all Indians.
Yeah.
Now, this went on and on. I saw him come with wounds that would have killed a lesser man. He was a Hercules among men. He was captured by General George Crook and others, but always managed to make his escape. Now, he says, when I was 25 years of age, I found myself in love with an Apache maiden named Katia.
Here we go, a love story.
Yep. You got to throw this in.
Yeah, I know.
Her father liked me, now that I was a blood brother, and gave her to me gratefully. I think that the real reason was that Geronimo spoke a good word for me.
Uh-huh.
But 2 days before we were to be husband and wife, she...
You could have used Geronimo at your high school prom.
I could have. She complained of a violent headache. And then she got a high fever.
Oh, my.
But...
You think I'm going to say any more? You're crazy.
Okay, this is a sad thing, Zeb.
Oh, yeah.
You can't laugh.
I'm sorry, I'm chuckling.
Okay. Anyway, so here he is in love with this beautiful Indian maiden. Well, she had this bad headache, high fever. She got one of the white man's illnesses, and she was dead in a week.
Oh, my goodness. That's more than an excuse.
Yeah.
Okay.
And now, this was 1885, and he was in his 20s. He says, I was brokenhearted, and Geronimo comforted me. He said, I, too, lost my love, he said, and tears came to his black eyes. He said, all men suffer in one way or another. Well, no one has ever heard this story, no one but you before. I hadn't intended telling that I went with Geronimo on his last big raid into Mexico.
Oh, my.
I guess maybe he was afraid of retaliation or something because he was one of Geronimo's
But, you know,
bands.
That's interesting that he would have a transition in his mind against basically his own people, the Mexicans,
right,
and raid back into his country against his people.
Right, exactly.
Holy smokes.
He said, I was full of anger at white men and their fevers and pox, sickness that we had never heard of before. I was full of anger at the Mexicanos because they had killed the family of Geronimo. So I went with him, and I helped to avenge my chief. This raid was the last big raid into that country.
Did he stop in and see his mom and say, hi, Mom?
You always get ahead of me.
I didn't know.
Now I can't. No, okay, I'll surprise you.
Okay, I'll act like I'm really shocked.
Okay,
go ahead.
All right. Now, not everyone was looking for Geronimo, but he was not really captured again until 1886 when, finding himself surrounded, he surrendered to General Miles.
Yeah.
Now, Geronimo was later sent to a fort in Oklahoma called Fort Seal.
Right, been there.
And he was a model prisoner. He kind of grew a little more mellow as we talked last week and did appearances and one thing and another. But he continues with his story. He said, I was a lonely man. I had not only lost Katia, but my beloved chief. I had truly been tried by fire. As I sat astride my Indian pony, I thought to myself, I have no one now, here. But something held me to these Apaches. I loved them. They were good people. I guessed that I would always be among them. I was a member of the Chiricahuas and would always be. Time seemed to go rapidly. I thought of my mother and father.
Mm.
Now, here we get to 1909.
Oh, my goodness. Let's see. He was born in 60, right?
Yeah. So, okay. he's getting up there.
All right.
When I heard that Geronimo was dead, he was 80 years old. Even though he had not been with us on the reservation, his presence was always felt.
Yeah.
So he continues, my whole outlook changed. I would return to Sonora, back to the little village of Magdalena. I bade a sad goodbye to all my brothers and waved a last wave in 1910. I carried with me scalping knife, Katia's beads, and 3 Indian blankets.
Wow.
When I rode into Sonora, I had gone 80 or so miles to Magdalena across the frontier. I was tired and worn out. The village was the same. Dusty streets, while my mount drank of the cool water at the well in the village, I inquired of a man about my parents. I was told that they still lived in the same old hogan.
His dad was still mad.
Yes. I left immediately. I stopped and tethered my pony to a willow tree beside the brook where I had been taken by Geronimo.
Oh, my
goodness. So long ago.
Oh, my.
I washed my hands and dried them on the grass. Then, leaving the pony to rest and drink, I walked to the hogan.
Oh, boy.
I stepped silently with the moccasins that were made to walk softly in and stood for a moment trying to remember everything that had happened on that eventful morning. Then I heard a stir inside the room. I called out softly, Madre, Padre, you know, mother, father.
Yes.
They walked feebly with pains of age and peered at me closely. I ran to them. I kissed and hugged them. They wept and laughed at the same time. My father said, what became of the calves?
Oh, my goodness. you had to throw that in.
You know, what happened to those cows?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's been 50 years. Anyway, and my mother said, are you well? Well, he said, I became the captain de policia, which I assume is the police chief.
Yeah, the police chief.
Sonora's little village
little
of,
city, yeah.
of Magdalena, and remained so for many years.
Really?
I could never listen to the talk of Geronimo's big raid on Mexico in the year 1885, and no one ever knew that I was with him.
Let me ask you a question there. You know, you mentioned that he came back into his home area. Now, did he have to alter or change his appearance? So there was so much hate for the Apaches.
You know, he doesn't say anything about
that. See, there's
that.
Your homework.
Yeah, and he's dead by now, so.
Well, what year did he pass away?
It says he, well, let's see, about 1910, I believe.
Yeah,
that's when he went back.
Yeah.
So, you know, he lived into the, I'm going to say maybe 1920.
Oh, my.
So he was, you know, got on in age, but, you know, kind of an interesting story.
Oh,
and I like this because it's his story,
yeah.
You know, told. And this came from a magazine that was published about 1962.
Yeah.
So.
Wouldn't it be nice, though, if there was some way to kind of concrete or solidify some of these parts of the story, like going back. Now, if they were raiding in Mexico and the Chiricahua Apaches were so hated and feared, you would think that he would have altered his dress or the way he looked so that he could go home without being feared. You understand what I'm
right,
trying to say?
Right, because, the Mexicans and the Americans...
They shoot him.
They would know by looking at him
yeah.
that he was an Apache.
Yeah.
So, that's a good question, and I don't know.
And be gone that long and be open about actually raiding with Geronimo and then to appoint him chief of police.
Yeah.
It kind of makes you wonder.
Well, you know, he must have been good at what he did.
Yeah.
But
that's a good story.
The Apaches were an interesting group.
Oh, boy.
I mean, I know we're about out of time, but I just had a thought here. It said the most nomadic nation in the Southwest, the Apache, became the last major Indian group to submit to American authority.
I've got a book someplace on these shelves, and for those of you at home, someplace on these shelves means like 10,000 books later, that goes into the Apaches, their lifestyle, how they were brought up, how they were made, as tough as they were, how they could go without water, how they could go without food. They really were, I would say, a precursor to kind of the U.S. Navy SEALs that we have
yeah.
today.
Well, and then I've got to note that the Apache group was actually divided into 6 distinct subgroups, and then the Western Apache were further subdivided into 14 bands. So
yeah.
it kind of trickled down. So when you say the word Apache, it really could encompass quite a few different sub-tribes, the Chiricahua, the Mescalero, the Western Apache, the one called the Jicarillo, and the Kiowa Apache. Yeah. So the Apache is kind of a, kind of a general term for all of those groups or tribes.
You did an excellent job today.
Thank you.
That was really a good story. Dr. History right here, brought to you by our dear friends at Minnacashia Sales, 1321 East Main Street in Burley. They've got everything. All you've got to do is just stop in and see what you need right there at Minnacashia Sales with Zach and the crew, 1321 East Main Street in Burley. By the way, Dr. History is going out of here with a Christmas present and a card and the well wishes from Deanne and I. Merry, Merry Christmas. What are we going to do next Tuesday? Are we going to have kind of the Christmas story?
Well, that's what I need to, we need to decide. You want me to do some kind of Christmas stuff next week?
Yeah, I think we should.
Okay.
Yeah, it's Christmas week, isn't it? Yeah, next week is Christmas.
Oh, it is.
Smokes, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Ed.
Yeah, we've got a lot of things to cover and we'll look forward to that. Thank you very much.
You have a good day.
All right, sir. Dr. History right here on Zeb at the Ranch. By the way, we've got some Christmas messages for you. Christmas wishes from Roggy Auction. Ron, Cade, Corey, and Jed, the best doggone auctioneers around. If you're selling farms or farm equipment, they can do the job for you. Roggy Auction wishing you a very Merry Christmas. And Representative Fred Wood, and he is so right when he says we live in a blessed country and we all should thank God for what we have here in the United States. Merry Christmas from Representative Fred Wood. Thank you very much. Right now, we're going to get ready to send this back over to our main studios at KBAR, and then we'll come back in about 3 or 4 minutes and be ready to go with a small little interview with Rick Martin at Mountain Transmissions. Don't you go away. Zeb at the Ranch will be back in about 3 minutes.
And now, back to Zeb at the Ranch on AM 1230 KBAR. To reach Zeb, call 436-2244 or toll free 1-866-927-4587. And now, here is Zeb Bell.
Thank you very much. And here we are on the home stretch for this morning, the last half hour. I want to wish Merry Christmas wishes to you from AMI, 719 Overland in Burley. Look for the big 28-foot wrench over the door. Go nuts over their bolts. I just, every time I say that, I chuckle. It's a great slogan. Alan, Corey, Eric, and Rob, and the rest of the crew at AMI wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas. Along with our friends at Streamline Precision, 120 South, 100 West of Burley, 678-9204. Tim and the rest of the crew, they can build your grain bins, commodity storage, they can build your dairies, whatever. You just get a hold of them today. Streamline Precision wishing you a Merry Christmas. And our friends at Golden Valley Warehouse, 468 West, 1000 South of Burley, 678-7324. They'd like to wish all of their customers Merry Christmas and tell them how much they appreciate them from Golden Valley Warehouse. Thank you very much. Okay, let's go to the phone lines right now, and we have with us on the phone, I believe, the gentleman that is the main man down at Mountain Transmissions in Burley. Rick Martin, how are you this morning?
I'm doing great, Jeff. How about you?
Not too bad. Well, now listen, you've got a brand spanking new business down there in the Burley area. How big an area do you serve fixing transmissions?
We serve the Minnecassa County area.
Okay. And tell me a little bit about transmissions. I got to tell you that when I was growing up, they still circled the wagons at night. But, you know, I had to learn on a manual transmission, and then all of a sudden the automatics really came into being. Boy, there's been a lot of changes, hasn't there?
Yes, there has. You know, now with the new style transmissions, everything's electronically controlled off the computer system with the vehicle of the car, with your ABS sensors, your throttle positioning sensors, your mass airflow sensors. You know, they all really work together to give you maximum performance on the vehicle.
You know, now let me ask you this, Rick. Everybody says the good old days. Are the transmissions made tougher today to withstand a larger pulling force?
You know, they are. Everybody talks about the good old days and transmissions, how they seem to go 10 years. But what they don't realize is back in the good old days, it would take 10 years to drive 100,000 miles.
That's
true. Traffic, you drive 100,000 miles in probably 3 to 5 years.
Right.
Now, and that is really what's happening is, you know, we put so many more miles on a vehicle than what we used to.
Now, you know, you talk about that, and we go and get a new pickup or a new car or whatever, and we drive, and we consider, you know, the oil changes, maybe every 3,000 or 4,000 miles, et cetera. What about those transmissions? We kind of forget about those, don't we?
You know, most people really do, and when you look at the owner's manual, they recommend anywhere between 50 to 100,000 miles. And, you know, that's really, you know, not to contradict what they say. They do manufacture, they do design it. But from my belief of rebuilding transmissions for over 30 years, they don't want you to get scared when somebody drops your pan and you see a little contamination thinking that you got a bad transmission while you're under warranty. Because all transmissions have contamination. That's why transmission fluid is such a high grade of detergents, because it's constantly cleaning the transmission out. I personally recommend every 2 year, 24,000 miles on a service.
Okay. Now, I am not a mechanic. I don't want to be. I don't care about getting greasy hands. I figured that if you can't saddle it and rope it, it's not worth having. But anyhow, as far as things to watch for, subtle little signs that say to you, me, or anybody else, hey, you got a problem with your tranny. What do we watch for or listen for?
Well, you know, the biggest thing is leaks. So many people bring their vehicle to me and it's been leaking for quite a long time, and what they don't realize is transmissions are a sealed unit and they should not leak. And all it takes is to a quarter to a fluid to run low on a transmission to start causing internal damage, especially to your clutch plates and your bands.
Okay.
So the first thing would be leaks. You know, it should not leak. The second thing would be slips, drips, and funny shifts.
Okay. Now, you say funny shifts, but for the neophyte that's not a mechanic and they really don't know what to look in and listen for, will they notice these changes so that they can become aware?
You know, a lot of people become accustomed to the way their vehicle shifts. They figure it's just wearing in. But honestly, all transmissions should shift responsive and smoothly. When you start getting harsh, jerky shifts, excessive overlapping in the RPMs when they shift, that's an indication of something's going wrong with the transmission inside, whether it be maybe a restricted filter, a shift solenoid that's partly clogging up with contamination. Those are the things to look for at first, and to get it addressed before it causes a major problem.
So now your business, I mean, you do repair work, you do rebuilds, clutch repair specialists, automatic standard, overdrives. I mean, man, if somebody's got a Great Bay pick'em up truck or a car, you can handle it.
Oh, yeah. I myself, I've been rebuilding professionally for over 30 years. I work on 5-ton down.
Oh, my.
Anything bigger than that, I just don't have the equipment to do it. We stock all the proper late model diagnostic equipment to check the vehicle, every make and model, Asian and import, American, domestic. We offer free diagnostics, free estimates. And, you know, basically in a nutshell, people think about the transmission man when they think about the dentist. When their mouth is starting to hurt, they think about the dentist.
Oh, boy.
When the transmission's starting to slip, they think about the transmission man.
I'll tell you what, and tell us where you're located and kind of give us a thumbnail sketch so that everybody can visualize where your location is.
We're located at 504 East Main in Burley. We're right next door to the skate park.
Okay.
And we're about 2 blocks down from the rodeo yards, the county fairground.
All right. And I'll tell you what, should they call first for an appointment? What would you have them do?
Yeah, I do everything by appointments. I do run just a small shop. It's me and one other gentleman. I'm not really, when I moved out here to Burley, I wanted to more or less semi-retire, take it easy, so I'm not trying to pile up cars.
Okay.
On cars one at a time, so I do everything by appointments.
Now, you got a special going on. I understand it's a transmission tune-up for just $89.95. Boy, that sounds like money well spent for preventative maintenance. What do you do?
Well, that is basically very little profit on that. It's basically a special I run to get people into the shop, to let them check out our facilities, meet and greet with me. And what I do is we road test the vehicle, make sure it's operating properly. We bring it up on the lift. We raise it. We check it for leaks. We scan the computer system. We check for any service codes, in the motor, in the transmission. And if everything's fine, then what we do is we drop the transmission pan. We do service. I would like to informize that. We service, we don't flush. Flushing is where you hook up a machine and you flush out all the old fluid and you put in new. What we do is we drop the transmission pan, we change the filter, which normally 9 times out of 10 is a Dacron filter. It's a cloth filter. We clean the magnet, we change about a little less than half of the fluid that comes out of the transmission, put a new pan gasket on. So it's more like an oil change where you change your oil filter and your oil, which is really important in transmissions because that filter can get restricted, it can get clogged, and it can cause a problem.
Absolutely. So basically, with this special and this tune-up, if there is any big problem that's looming on the horizon, you can possibly spot it right then, right?
Oh, yeah, exactly. When we drop the transmission pan, if we notice any excessive contamination, I always recommend to the customer that, you know, whether we should remove it, inspect, and repair it at this time and save them some money, or they have the choice to go ahead and service it and drive it, and if they notice anything starting to happen, I recommend getting it in right away.
All right. We've been talking to Rick Martin over at Mountain Transmissions at 504 East Main in Burley. Number to call, 678-9110. And there's only one more thing I've got to do, Rick, and that's wish you a very Merry Christmas.
Well, and I would like to wish you a very Merry Christmas and just correct you on my name. It's Rick Mitchell.
Oh, I got Martin down here. I'm sorry. And you know what? I'm going to take the blame for that because I was talking to a gentleman earlier and I wrote that down wrong. And I want you to slap me upside the face when I come down to see you.
Well, you know, you have a very Merry Christmas, and me and my family, we're very happy to be in the Burley area. And thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to be on the air with you.
Hey, God bless you, man. And I'm so sorry I made the mistake, and I need to be chastised. Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
All righty. Well, you have a good day.
All right. Take care. Rick over at Mountain Transmissions. And, you know, that's what I get for trying to take two phone calls at one time and then transposing the names. That's embarrassing. We'll live through it. Good morning, and thanks to Rick over there. Nice guy. Mountain Transmissions at 504 East Main in Burley. The number to call, 678-9110. Calls are welcome and appreciated right now, so give me a jingle on the landline. And I think what we'll do, excuse me for that cough again, can't get rid of that thing. We're going to have our weather forecast, and it's brought to you this hour by Scarrow's Meats. Oh my goodness, they've got that great big harvest bundle, and you get beef, and you get pork, and you get chicken, you get 32 pounds of meat. Oh my goodness, it's delicious. And satisfaction guaranteed, $79 plus tax at Scarrow's Meats, 331 North Road, Jerome, and the number to call, 324-7657. And they have that harvest bundle. It is good. Right now, let's go to Gina and the weather.
Here's your weather forecast as we are inching our way closer towards Christmas, but we still have about 11 days left. Looks like partly cloudy skies for today, slightly breezy winds out of the southwest, right around 14 miles an hour, high of 28 for today. Tonight, low of 21. Tomorrow, expecting some afternoon snow showers, about a 50% chance. Still going to be windy out of the west, about 15 miles an hour, high of 30 with an overnight low of 23. Cloudy and 33 for Thursday, and partly cloudy and 40 for Friday. Yesterday's high was 31. The overnight low was 27. That's your weather for Zebeth Ranch.
Thank you very much. And right now, let's remind you, Scarrow's Meats, they guarantee everything they sell, and everything they sell is delicious at 331 North Road, Jerome. The number to call, 324-7657. Excuse me. Your calls are welcome and appreciated. 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. I have a story here. I'm going to have an awful hard time getting through this story because when I read this for the first time early this morning, as it was sent to me by Washington, D.C., and the Daily Caller, I read this and I started to cry. And then I've got to be very honest with you. After the tears, anger absolutely overwhelmed me to the point of wanting to be in the Oval Office with Obama and other members of his administration, particularly John Kerry. And I wanted to shake them until they finally started to realize what they are not doing to protect America and the world. Let me read some of this to you, and it's absolutely hideous. Islamic State religious leaders have ordered that all children born with Down syndrome be executed immediately. Unconfirmed reports claim ISIS Sharia judges have made a fatwa, which is a religious decree or order, instructing ISIS fighters to murder newborn babies with Down syndrome or congenital deformities and disabled children. This fatwa is in effect, and according to a person that filed this report with news media, going to the Daily Caller, 38 children have already been executed, mostly by lethal injection and suffocation. Ladies and gentlemen, is that the world that you want to live in? Does this story not wake you up as to the absolutely heinous vermin that are out there in the world today and here in this country that want to kill us and take over our country? I just absolutely was appalled when I read this, and some of the reports, according to Renata Winter of the United Nations Committee on the Rights of the Child, they had a quote and they said, "We have had reports of children, especially children who are mentally challenged, who have also been used as suicide bombers, and most of them had no clue, no understanding at all as to what they were doing or what they were about to do." These fatwas are religious decrees made by experts in the Islamic Sharia law that are similar to the Supreme Court rulings. And listen to this next sentence. All religious Muslims are supposed to follow a fatwa if it is determined to be well-founded. However, it is up to the individual to determine whether or not they will respect the decree. That leaves the door open, doesn't it? What a world. What an absolutely sinister, evil world when ISIS is ordering that all children born with Down syndrome, those that have disabilities, be executed or be used as suicide bombers. I don't know what to say. And like I said, this was a very hard story for me to try to relate. But this is the world today. This is not some fairy tale. This is not something that's conjured up by news sources or some fiction writer writing a book. This is going on right now, and we are allowing it to happen. And we're allowing it to be perpetrated in thought, word, and deed because of what's going on with this, I think, very sinister administration. Give me your thoughts. Call me, please, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. If this doesn't bother you to the point of making you run to a phone and exercise your free speech and just absolutely denounce what's going on in the world, I don't know what else could. My heart goes out to the families. My heart goes out to these children. And I pray to the good Lord above, He will have mercy on us. for these heinous acts. Please give me a call, 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. That is unbelievable. Well, I have just a moment, and I'm waiting for your call. I want to remind you about your Magic Valley Leshwam Tire Centers. All seven locations serving you, and service is the key word. They have all the best treaded snow tires for you to get through all the mud, the muck, and the snow. And, of course, they've got all the studded tires. They've got everything you need. The tire chains, the snow wheels, everything. Along with the best in brake service, the best in front end alignment, shocks and struts and batteries. You better believe it. But service always remains supreme. They really care about getting you in, getting you out, getting you back on the road. Stop in and see Lane and Rupert. Excuse me. Dave on Blue Lakes and Twin, Mike and Buell, Mike and Jerome, the Twist family in Paul, John on Poline in Twin Falls, and Randy on Overland in Burley. The best. Your Magic Valley Leshwam Tire Centers. I really am surprised. I got to take a sip of water. Hold on just a second. I really am surprised that the phone lines aren't lighting up. These are just atrocities that absolutely have to be denounced. And for our government or any government in the world not to say this is completely outrageous and make plans to just eradicate, wipe off the face of the earth these vermin, I don't know why it isn't being done. For Obama to stand up and say that his plan and his strategy is working, when they have sorties of bombers going over into that area and many times not even dropping the bombs, and the day before dropping leaflets telling the enemy they're going to drop the bombs. And then we hear about ISIS taking children with Down syndrome and executing them. And you think for a minute that this world isn't going to hell? Call me. 436-2244, 1-866-927-4587. Excuse me. I want to remind you again, while I'm waiting for your call, that Denny's Old Fashioned Merry Christmas is going to be tomorrow at 611 Overland in Burley. We're going to be down there and broadcasting the entire show from 8 to 11 right there at Denny's. We are going to have, and we're blessed to have, some of the Burley High School Choir. They're going to be singing Christmas carols. We're going to have door prizes. We're going to have Santa Claus there. We're going to have the Loot in the Boot, where you can chip in and help some of the needy families and charities in the area. We're going to have Ken Mord singing, and it's just going to be a great old-fashioned Christmas celebration right down there at Denny's at 611 Overland tomorrow. We're broadcast from 8 to 11, so we hope that you can be there with us at Denny's tomorrow morning. I guess I am shocked that we didn't get any callers in on that last subject, that last story, but here at Christmas time, when we think of brotherly love and compassion for our neighbors and our families, and what we can do to help our fellow man, and what we can do to make the world a little bit better. And then we hear a report as heinous as this. These aren't human beings. ISIS and their leaders are not human beings. They are evil personified. And they must be killed. They must be stricken from the face of the earth. I think what I'll do at this time is I'm going to ask my dear friend Wheels over at the station. I really have nothing more to say about this subject for this morning. I'm out of words.
I understand.
I'm just so full of contempt right now for these people. I'm going to ask you, my dear friend, if maybe could make light somewhat of this situation, and a little Christmas music to lead us out of the show. And I'll remind everybody again that we will be at Denny's Restaurant tomorrow at 611 Overland in Burley. Wheels, a little Merry Christmas to you. Thank you for the excellent job you do, and we'll see everybody tomorrow on the radio at 8:06. God bless, and the way things were, the way things ought to be.